Hello friends, I am S.R. Dulange, working as an associate professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss on workpiece control theory. Now, this workpiece control theory is related with tool engineering as well as process engineering. Now we are taking this particular topic in process engineering. Learning outcome: students will be acquainted with workpiece control theory and understand 3-to-1 principle of location for process planning. Now, under workpiece control theory, the first we are going to see what is 3-to-1 principle and what is redundant. Now, under workpiece control theory, the 3-to-1 location system or the concept of location we are going to discuss based on the flat configuration workpieces. Now, what is the location? Location is nothing but to maintain a dimensional and position relationship between the workpiece and the cutting tool. And what is the meaning of the locator? Locator is an element which is used for the location. Now, in order to constrain the degrees of freedom for a particular workpiece, when we are doing operation, we require the location along with clamping. Now, this is a cube wherein we are assuming that this is in space. Now, when we are assuming this workpiece is in space, so this is the x-axis of the workpiece, this is the y-axis of the workpiece, and this is the z-axis of the workpiece. Now, how many moments will be there for this particular cube? Now, along x-axis there will be two moments. Here I can say this is one side, this is another side. Along y-y there are two moments, one is upward, another is downward. Along z there are two moments, this one and that one. So, along the each axis there will be six moments, and these moments are called as moment of translation. So, similarly along each axis there will be some moment of rotation. Now, this moment of rotation is divided in two, that is, one is clockwise, another is anticlockwise. So, along x-axis there is one clockwise, one anticlockwise. Along y-axis there is one clockwise, another is anticlock. Along z-axis one clockwise, and along the z-axis one is anticlockwise. So there will be six moment of rotation. So in all there are six moment of translation and six moment of rotation. This is called as a 12 degree of freedom. Now, in order to constrain these 12 degrees of freedom, we have to make use of the locator and the clamp. Now here 3-to-1 principle suggests that you can take three mutually perpendicular planes in order to constrain some degrees of freedom. So that is shown here in this view. Now here one locator is taken at the bottom plane. Now this is a front view and this is the top view. So this is a rectangle, indicates a symbol for the locator. Now this is a side view for that. Now because of this one locator, it stops a linear movement downward along YY axis because the locator is kept at the bottom of the workpiece. Now the second locator is taken again at the bottom surface. So second locator stops the rotation about axis ZZ. Now this is shown here. 1 and 2 locator. So these are the two locators which are taken at the bottom. One more locator is taken at the bottom in order to see how many moments are restricted. So this is 1, 2 and 3. So when we take these three locators at the bottom, so what will happen? The workpiece will not rotate along XX axis. Similarly, it will not rotate along ZZ axis. And it will not go in downward direction along y-axis. Means by making use of these three points or these three locations, we can constrain 5 degrees of freedom, That is, one is xx rotation along xx, clock anti-clockwise, rotation along z, that is clock anti-clockwise, and the moment of translation, that is the locator will not allow the workpiece to come at the bottom, right? So it will constant 5 degrees of freedom. Now next is, this is 3. Now why we have taken 3 pins? If suppose we take 2, what will happen? There is a possibility that the workpiece may rotate along either clock or anti-clockwise because of the position of that locator. So that's why we are not going to take 2 locators at the bottom. Now because of the 3, we are going to get a plane because the plane passes through the 3 points. If suppose we take a 4th locator, now the 4th locator at the bottom plane, what will happen? It will be unnecessary, there is no need for that particular location. So this is called as redundant. Now, so this is the first plane which is taken in order to constrain 5 degrees of freedom. Now the next plane is taken, that is a perpendicular to the bottom plane. So this is the bottom plane and these are the 2 location points which are perpendicular to the bottom plane. Now because of these 2, what will happen? So this workpiece will not move in left direction. So this is a direction from my side, it is a left, so it will not move along left direction. And this is the axis, y-axis. So here, this vertical axis is a y-axis. Because of the plane, this is a plane which we have taken in order to have a location by means of 2 points. So there will not be any rotation along this y-y-axis. So there is no rotation along y-y-axis, either it is a clock or anti-clock. And there is no movement towards the left side. So because of these 2 pins, what will happen? We can constraint 3 degrees of freedom. That is the rotation along YY, that is clock and anti, and one is the left side. Now this principle suggests that go for 3 mutually perpendicular planes. Now this is a plane which we have taken, that is a bottom plane, and the second plane which we have taken, that is a perpendicular to the bottom plane. So this bottom plane is having 3 point location and the perpendicular plane to the bottom plane is having the 2 point location or the 2 locators. Now because of this bottom 3 pins and because of this side 2 pins, we could able to constraint 8 degrees of freedom. Now 3 mutually perpendicular planes are taken, in that case the third plane will be this one, that is a, here it indicates a 6. So 1, 2 and 3 which are at the bottom. So this dot indicates on the triangle is, that is the pins are kept at the bottom side. And 4th, 5th, that is the plane which is perpendicular to the bottom plane. And the 3rd mutually perpendicular plane, here this is a 6th locator. Because of this, what will happen? It will not move away from me in this way. So it will constrain 1 degree of freedom. Means what? By making use of 3 pins at the bottom, 2 pins at the another plane which is perpendicular to the bottom plane, and the 6th pin which is mutually perpendicular to both the planes, we could able to constrain 5 plus 3 plus 1, that is 9 degree of freedom. Now here one more 7th pin is shown. This is called as redundant, as I already told. Now here the 6th is taken. If suppose we take 6th and 7th on this plane, it is not necessary because this 6th is constraining only 1 degree of freedom. So this is what a 3-to-1 principle, which is required in the process engineering in order to have a planning for the process. Now these are the references. Thank you.